led you this way. Just make yourself right at home, and let's worship Jesus today. Let him have his way and will with all of us. We'll start by singing a song together.
If you would stand and turn to page 401, the unclouded sky.
An email to read here. It's from Jackson Neighbors in Need. It says, I wanted to share that I made good use of one of the hygiene kits for a young lady in need. She basically had nothing, no way to get home to Tennessee. They helped her with a room. The kit helped her. Silver Linings donated clothes. And we got her a bus ticket back home. New Hope is a wonderful example of selfless giving. This is from the board member. Laura Chapman, and I was told that we collected a total of $950 to give to this particular ministry. So thank the Lord for that. By way of announcements, Richard wanted me to mention that the contacting committee is going to be hunting you down, finding those who have been nominated for the different offices, and letting you know what that is. And we want to ask you to prayerfully consider those things. Don't just think about, well, do I want to do this? Really think about, does God want me to do this? Is that what he's wanting you to do, to fill that role and that position? They're all important, and it's important that we be in the one God wants us to be in. So ask you to do that. Any other announcements today?
And if you have a graduate from preschool all the way up to college, if you would let us know that by today, please.
Any other announcements? Okay, pray for our choir.
Number 6 in your song.
Mm-hmm. Somebody passed the book down. Boy, it feels good in here this morning. Good to be saved today. Got to thinking here a while back, it's going to be 50 years next year. And there's been a lot of people say it, but I say it from the bottom of my heart. It still amazes me how he loved me. It's an amazing thing to be saved.
Amen.
The world laughs about that right now. These days, boy, that's going to be one of the greatest things about your life, is that you're saved when he comes back. Wow, yes, me, no embarrassment then. They ask me to sing every time I get choked up. Let's pray for us. We're singing. Thank God for the blessed hope that we have in Jesus Christ. Home. Home. This is not my home. I'm only passing through this place. Headed to Beulah Land. Beulah Land. Why, eye has not seen, ear has not heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man what God has prepared for those that love him. But the next verse says, the Spirit has revealed it to it. Greg, I might have not have saw it, I heard it, or whatever, but the Spirit tells me down inside, old Marvin, boy, is he homesick for another place. why do you think all this stuff going on tires me up so much? Because I can't do a thing about it, and I'm stuck here for right now. But one day I'll be free. Wow. In Beulah Land. Thank God for his promises. I'm kind of whole, sick for a country to which I've never been before. No sad time won't matter anymore.
Beulah Land, I'm longing for you.
tell you, I'm
bless you, Lord.
Somebody's going to talk. Go ahead, brother.
A year ago today, the Lord called my mom. And he just ain't, you know, he just not the tears of hurt and heartache. The tears of hurt. Because my mom's right where she was today.
That's the Lord.
These are the tears of missing her every day. The tears of my mom was my best friend. But Martin was saying that song to you. Eternity. Eternity's a long time, buddy. A long time. I ain't figured it out yet. Neither is anybody else. But that hope and assurance we have that one day, once we leave here and get out of these sinful bodies, God, don't take this wrong way, because I hate this body if I live. Because all it does is drag my soul every day. And I've been reading about that a whole lot. And that's, what else? It drags your soul down. When our soul gets out of this body and gets in the presence of the Lord, we ain't got it, but I can't imagine how happy my mother is. I know she is, and I ain't got no fear. Today is the day of my mom. A year ago, she was set free and got to go home. Today is not a sad day. It's a good day. Okay. If you don't know that, folks, we're all going to die. And if you don't know, when the Lord comes and them two angels come and get you and take you home, know that the angels are coming to get you because you don't want to trust them. I don't know. That'd be. I don't know where I'm at. I'm thankful that the way they let me grow with each other. I'm thankful that Mama dragged me to church. Even when I got too big and I'll have to go, she still does. Thankful that the Lord chose me.
What's on my heart today is, yes, Marvin said it, just how homesick I feel. But also how happy I am, how thankful I am that there's a better place than this. Place that is nothing but love, peace, and joy, and comfort forever and ever and ever. I've never known that, but I'm going to. And I'm looking forward to it so much. And I just want to praise God today that I've got a home in heaven, that this is not my real home, that I'm going there someday, and I believe it'll be soon. And my desire for everybody here today is that you could say the same thing, that you would have that same assurance in your heart this morning, that you're going to heaven, that you're going to that better place, that you know you've been saved, that you know you've been born again. And so if you don't have that confidence, that peace in your heart this morning, how I pray that God will speak to you right now. And that if he does speak to you, that you will listen, that you will hear what he is saying to you. Because he will speak to you personally, directly, if you'll let him. So this morning, I just feel like we were to stand. And as God speaks to us today, about whatever it might be, whatever the need of our heart or life is, wherever we stand with him this morning, and we'll do what he tells us to do. Please do that today.
struggling. I don't know why God's telling me to say this, but I can feel it. I can remember back before I was saved. I just thank God that He waited on me because I was under conviction before. And I left church that day without going to the altar. There's a way that you sometimes, your head can override your heart. And you can tell yourself, I don't want nobody looking at me.
Yes,
I don't want to go up there. What are people going to think? Just come. Let God guide you. I'm just so thankful that He gave me another time to come to church. So if someone's here today and your heart's beating fast and you're even thinking it, just come. Ernie will meet you right here. We're all going to pray with you. Don't think we're looking at you or judging you.
That's right. We've all been there. We all had to make that same, push that same decision. I fully believe what they just sung, don't you?
Yes.
It's going to be worth it after all. Sometimes we might wonder. We might begin to question that. But there is one thing that can never be taken away from me. And that's what God's done for me and what I've done for Him. Everything else I'm going to leave behind. Everything else will be somebody else's someday. But what He did for me, saving me, blessing me in so many ways, can't nobody take that from me. And the works that I've done for Him, they're going to follow me into eternity. Nothing else really matters. Just what we do for Him and what He's done for us. Where are you with Him this morning? Maybe you are struggling, like the sister said. You can put an end to that today. Not by yourself, not by your own doing, but by trusting the Lord and coming to Him today. Letting Him help you. Because He is the one person who truly can. Have you already picked out something to sing? Already got something? Go ahead.
Coming soon, where the
here this morning, most I'm glad I'm saved. And, you know, God has brought me through so much, and I praise God every day for what He's done for me. He brought me through cancer, He brought me through fire. But most of all, when I was lost and undone, He saved my soul. He sent His only begotten Son to die on that old red cross for all of us. And you know, we need to praise Him more day and day. Because you know, this whole world, it's a mess. I mean, a complete mess. But one of these days, that mess is going to be solved, Lord. Because Jesus is coming soon. And I hope everybody's ready to go. You know, I pray every day, every night, that God will reach down and He'll save the sinners that promise. And you know, I've got love in my heart for everybody. But God has got more love than I have. So reach out to Him. And Crystal, can you sing Chainbreaker? I know I love this song. I guess poor little Crystal is tired of singing. Ever since I heard it, I loved it. I fell in love with song. Let's listen to the words.
Thank you. There's a day just out in front of us, I know will surely come. That eastern sky will open wide, revealing God's dear Son. And I know from here to heaven, it's but the twinkling of an eye. And in the midst of all His glory, we'll hear the sweetest cry. Welcome home, I knew. Was it worth the wait? Welcome home. Step through the gate. I believe at least for me, I'll see my mom and dad, my brothers and my sisters. Everywhere you look are friends. All the greetings will be precious from those we've loved so dear. No mortal man has ever seen or heard what we'll hear. Welcome home, I knew you'd come. Welcome home, you're here for good. And look around. Was it worth the wait? Welcome home. Step through the gate. Welcome home. I knew you'd come. Welcome home. You're here for good. And look around. Was it worth
church, just pray. When you ain't got nothing that you can say or do good for one another, just pray. It goes such a long way, and people feel those prayers, and they feel hope, and it gives them strength when there's nothing else that they have hope for.
Amen.
And I know Ernie said it 1,000 times, but God, Satan is attacking our families. And right now I'm at my weakest point, and I'm just asking for prayers to please help me battling. I don't know what God has in store for me. I have no idea. All I can do is pray for His will at this point. And I know that. But I would still give anything to have my family sitting there in that row right now.
All heads to be bowed and all eyes to be closed. What I'm hearing, there's a lot of people who are burdened here this morning, and they may be burdened for you. You might be the one that God's put on their heart. I don't know, but you do. And so I wonder this morning, nobody looking around, nobody at all, just me and the Lord. Would you be willing to just lift your hand today and say, "Preacher, it's me. I'm the one that's troubled. I'm the one that's struggling. I'm the one that God's dealing with. And so I'm the one that needs you to pray for me." Could you do that? Just acknowledge what's going on inside your heart today. Be honest with yourself. Be honest with God. And we can go from there. Would you do that? Say, "It's me, preacher. Pray for me. I need you to pray for me. I need God to do something for me today. Or I need to do what God's telling me to do today." Only you and God know your heart. I don't want anybody to miss out here this morning, to deny themselves God's blessings in any way. You're the only one who can do that, you know. But you can. Unless you trust Him in belief. Right, no hands were raised. I take you at your word, because that's all I can do. All heads up, all eyes. I like what Kayla said there about being a different church. Some people might look at us this morning and say, "What's wrong with that crowd? What are they doing?" That's good. I want to be different. I don't want the world to be able to figure me out, do you? But I want them to want what we've got. So let's do. Let's be that different church. Not talking about each other. Not gossiping about each other. But praying for each other. And loving each other. That's what God put us here to do. To be a family. To support one another. And encourage each other. And lift each other up. Well, we've sung about heaven a lot today, haven't we? I think we needed to be reminded of that. One of the lines of that song was talking about madness. What better word to describe the world we're living in today than madness? Just seems like that's all it is, madness everywhere. One day that's going to be over. It will not last forever. Let me say one more thing. I feel like God wants me to do this. And if nobody feels moved to receive it in any way, we'll go home. But God may be dealing with somebody about joining this church. Maybe He's leading you to new hope. That this is where you know God wants you to be. So I'm just giving you a personal invitation right now. That if you know that's what God wants you to do, you come. And you let Him have His way.
If you're here and you're not saved, the time's going to come. One day the Lord's going to call you home, and He's going to say,
"Time, brother.
Welcome home, my good and faithful servant." He's going to say, "Depart from me, for I've never knew you." I hope if you're here and you're not saved, I hope it's the first and not the second.
Remind me your first name again.
Remind me
your first name again. Shirley. I had a feeling about these two. May Maybe somebody I don't know about, but God does. Is this supposed to be your church home, your church family? Come be a part of it. God wants you here. We definitely want you here. All right, this is Mr. Ray and Mrs. Shirley Presley. Ray told me he, a while back, he believed God was leading him this way. And today's the day, brother. Is that right?
Yes.
Amen. I think they're members of Black Mountain. Is that right? All right. Do I hear a motion? Moved and second. All in favor, let it be known by saying aye.
Aye.
That sounded pretty unanimous to me, didn't she? Amen. We're thankful God's led these folks our way. And if you're one of the ones he's working on, well, we just pray that you'll let him lead you where he wants you to be. It's a good feeling, ain't it, brother?
It is.
Amen. I know these are still strange times we're living in, but I just want to say, if you feel like coming around shaking these folks' hands, welcoming our church family, by all means you do that. We're just trusting the Lord anyway. He's in control. So.
I stood in the courtroom. The judge turned my way. Looks like he walked in and pleaded my case.
See if the Lord's done yet or not. Sometimes I get ahead of him a little bit. Our hearts and minds clear. If not, please say something now. Everything good between you and God. Got peace between you and the Lord. Because if you don't, you can have it. I'll stay here all day if that's what it takes.
Me too. I'll get that altar and stay all day.
It's up to you. I can't do it for you. Nobody else can. It's your decision. Are you going home feeling good? Spiritually.
I'll be back through there.
You ever been in a service where the preacher would say, this is it, last verse. This is what you've been waiting on? Here it is. Okay? You ask God to sing one more. He answered your prayer.
He's fair. He started over.
It's all right if everybody comes around. Shake Shane, you all right with that? Okay. All right. I said God was going to give us one more verse, and he did. If you asked for it and you didn't take advantage of it, it's on you. I just pray that God will give you another chance and extend mercy your way. He's been good to us here today, folks. He showed up, and I'm glad he did. Like I say, if you feel comfortable, you come around, you welcome these folks to our church's family. This is one of those where you just unhook, and you come back next time. God bless you, and I love you.